Hi there, I'm Harry from Used IP and today we're booting up our QNAP to a local monitor for the first time. Once your screen loads, you'll be presented with a login page. Your username and password will be default unless you've changed it. That'll be admin for the username and admin for the password. Here I'm showing you that you don't need a USB keyboard connected as there is an on-screen one available. Now that you've logged in, you'll be on the main interface that you may be familiar with if you have previously used the web browser version. Your interface may be different depending on the model and firmware of the device, but make sure you're on the latest firmware for the device to get the best results. If you don't know how to do this, there is a how-to guide in our blog showing you how to do this via the web browser. By clicking on the playback button at the top left of the interface, it will bring you to a new screen in which you can view all your recordings. You can choose what camera, the day, time and speed of the footage by using the slider at the bottom. There is also an option to view in full screen. Now I'll show you the settings menu, which has the same settings as the web browser application but is laid out slightly differently. Here's just a few examples of the various features of the settings that you can use, such as setting up your cameras, configuring your hard drives, network settings, and much more. In the last part of the video, I'm showing you how to configure your screen resolution, as when you first boot up the system, its defaults may not be correct for your monitor. This Linux-based QNAP system is simple and easy to use, and I'd recommend it to any user. If you'd like to view this product and more like it, please visit useip.co.uk. Thank you for watching once again and please continue to follow this series here on YouTube and our blog at www.blog.useip.co.uk.